Gene Flow, Wikipedia Audio. In population genetics, gene flow is the transfer of genetic variation from one population to another. If the rate of gene flow is high enough, then two populations are considered to have equivalent genetic diversity and therefore effectively a single population. It has been shown that it takes only one migrant per generation to prevent population diverging due to drift. Gene flow is an important mechanism for transferring genetic diversity among populations. Migrants into or out of a population may result in a change in allele frequencies, changing the distribution of genetic diversity within the populations. Immigration may also result in the addition of new genetic variants to the established gene pool of a particular species or population. High rates of gene flow can reduce the genetic differentiation between the two groups, increasing homogeneity. For this reason, gene flow has been thought to constrain speciation by combining the gene pools of the groups, and thus, preventing the development of differences in genetic variation that would have led to full speciation. There are a number of factors that affect the rate of gene flow between different populations. Gene flow is expected to be lower in species that have low dispersal or mobility, occur in fragmented habitats, there is long distance between populations, and smaller population sizes. Mobility plays an important role in the migration rate as a highly mobile individuals tend to have greater migratory potential. Animals tend to be more mobile than plants, although pollen and seeds may be carried great distances by animals or wind. As dispersal distance decreases, gene flow is impeded and inbreeding, measured by the inbreeding coefficient, increases. For example, many island populations have low rates of gene flow due to geographically isolated and small population size. The black-footed rock wallaby has several inbred populations that live on various islands off the coast of Australia. The population is so strongly isolated that gene flow is not a possibility, leading to high occurrences of inbreeding. Decrease in population size leads to increased divergence due to drift, while migration reduces divergence and inbreeding. Gene flow can be measured by using the effective population size, N, E, and the net migration rate per generation. Using the approximation based on the island model, the effect of migration can be calculated for a population in terms of the degree of genetic differentiation, F, S, T. This formula accounts for the proportion of total molecular marker variation among populations, averaged over loci. When there is one migrant per generation, the inbreeding coefficient, F, S, T, equals 0.2. However, when there is less than one migrant per generation, the inbreeding coefficient rises rapidly, resulting in fixation and complete divergence, F, S, T, equals 1. The most common, F, S, T, is 0.25. This means there is some migration happening. Measures of population structure range from 0 to 1. When gene flow occurs via migration, the deleterious effects of inbreeding can be ameliorated. Measuring gene flow. F, S, T, equals, 1/4, N, E, M, plus, 1. The formula can be modified to solve for the migration rate when F, S, T is known, N, M equals 1/1 F, S, T 1/4, N, M equals number of migrants. When gene flow is blocked by physical barriers, This results in allopatric speciation or a geographical isolation that does not allow populations of the same species to exchange genetic material. Physical barriers to gene flow are usually, but not always, natural. They may include impassable mountain ranges, oceans, or vast deserts. In some cases, they can be artificial, man-made barriers, such as the Great Wall of China, which has hindered the gene flow of native plant populations. One of these native plants, Ulmus pumila, demonstrated a lower prevalence of genetic differentiation than the plants Vitex negundo, ZZ Fus jujuba, Heteropappus hispidus, and Prunus armeniaca, whose habitat is located on the opposite side of the Great Wall of China where Ulmus pumila grows. This is because Ulmus pumila has wind pollination as its primary means of propagation and the latter plants carry out pollination through insects. Samples of the same species which grow on either side have been shown to have developed genetic differences, because there is little to no gene flow to provide recombination of the gene pools. Barriers to gene flow need not always be physical. Sympatric speciation happens when new species from the same ancestral species arise along the same range. This is often a result of a reproductive barrier. For example, two palm species of Howea found on Lord Howe Island were found to have substantially different flowering times correlated with soil preference, resulting in a reproductive barrier inhibiting gene flow. Species can live in the same environment, yet show very limited gene flow due to reproductive barriers, fragmentation, specialist pollinators, or limited hybridization or hybridization yielding unfit hybrids. A cryptic species is a species that humans cannot tell is different without the use of genetics. Moreover, gene flow between hybrid and wild populations can result in loss of genetic diversity via genetic pollution, assortative mating and outbreeding. Horizontal gene transfer refers to the transfer of genes between organisms in a manner other than traditional reproduction, either through transformation, conjugation, transduction, or GDA-mediated transduction. Viruses can transfer genes between species. Bacteria can incorporate genes from dead bacteria, exchange genes with living bacteria, and can exchange plasmids across species boundaries. Sequence comparisons suggest recent horizontal transfer of many genes among diverse species, including across the boundaries of phylogenetic domains. Thus, determining the phylogenetic history of a species cannot be done conclusively by determining evolutionary trees for single genes. Biologist Gogerton suggests the original metaphor of a tree no longer fits the data from recent genome research. Biologists instead use the metaphor of a mosaic to describe the different histories combined in individual genomes and use the metaphor of an intertwined net to visualize the rich exchange and cooperative effects of horizontal gene transfer. Using single genes as phylogenetic markers, it is difficult to trace organismal phylogeny in the presence of HGT. Combining the simple coalescence model of cladogenesis with rare HGT events suggests there was no single last common ancestor that contained all of the genes ancestral to those shared among the three domains of life. Each contemporary molecule has its own history and traces back to an individual molecule sen ancestor. However, these molecular ancestors were likely to be present in different organisms at different times. Naturally evolved, region-specific species can be threatened with extinction through genetic pollution, potentially causing uncontrolled hybridization, introgression, and genetic swamping. These processes can lead to homogenization or replacement of local genotypes as a result of either a numerical and/or fitness advantage of introduced plant or animal. Non-native species can threaten native plants and animals with extinction by hybridization and introgression, either through purposeful introduction by humans or through habitat modification, bringing previously isolated species into contact. These phenomena can be especially detrimental for rare species coming into contact with more abundant ones, which can occur between island and mainland species. Interbreeding between the species can cause a swamping of the rarer species' gene pool, creating hybrids that supplant the native stock. The extent of this phenomenon is not always apparent from outward appearance alone. While some degree of gene flow occurs in the course of normal evolution, hybridization with or without introgression may threaten a rare species' existence. For example, the mallard is an abundant species of duck that interbreeds readily with a wide range of other ducks and poses a threat to the integrity of some species. Barriers to gene flow. Allopatric speciation. Sympatric speciation. Gene flow between species. Horizontal gene transfer. Genetic pollution. Examples.